Welcome to George's workshop. It's a bit of a mess today. I'm working on lighting. I'm working on the fluorescent lights on the ceiling. You can see I have quite a few fluorescent lights. I've taken down the ones on the ceiling and I have them over on the other side where I can do tests on them, and together with a whole bunch of newer alternatives like LED bulbs and LED tubes in order to judge which gives the brightest light with the least amount of power. Now here's the test jig I've set up. My purpose today is to run you through how I do the test. All the tests are the same. I'm comparing all different alternatives. I put them up on the rack. I connect them to the voltage. The power comes in here. It goes through this variable transformer to this power bar, to this meter, and up to the light fixture. And then I have in the center a photometer. This one measures lux, and I have a temperature meter. So we're going to start. I'm going to run through a test. I've done it dozens of times here. You can see it's very cold today. There's two temperatures. One is the temperature up on the frame here. This is the thermocouple here. The other one is inside the fixture mounted with tape onto the ballast. So I can measure the ambient air temperature and the temperature of the ballast. The bottom one here, I don't know if you can see that, the bottom one minus 0.8 is the temperature of the room. And the photometer, will turn that on, and normally I have a little bit of background. That's 1.8 lux. The sun's coming in through the window behind me, and that's causing that. We would normally subtract that from whatever reading we get. Normally I do these tests when it's dark, like in the early morning. So, and here's the test sheet. I've done this again several dozen times. I have time at 0, 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15, etc. And then I have the foot candles, the amps, the watts, power factor, and the two temperatures. So let's begin. I have my pen behind my ear because it's so cold. Let's start by recording the room air temperature and the ballast temperature. And also, we're going to just check. This meter is a kilowatt. Two hands here, and we're going to record the voltage. I found that it isn't very sensitive to voltage. Voltage is actually fairly high right now, 118, well, let's call that 118.5. We just checked that. I've found that these lamps aren't too sensitive to the voltage. And plug this back in and turn it on, and we notice that the lux jumps up to about 9. I'll record that as 8.9, and now we want to measure the current. That's 40.42 amps, and the watts about 50. And the power factor, and I'll explain all these in my notes. That's the hertz, the frequency, and this is the power factor, 0.99. And then the last thing we do is this: we switch the meter over to time, and then I wait for 5 minutes to show up. We're coming up now on 5 minutes. The reason I'm doing this in the freezing cold is because fluorescent lights don't like cold. And as you probably noticed, they don't get very bright. And they stay dimmer at a lower temperature. So I'm trying to record the temperature carefully, and so I can make comparisons between different styles of ballast and lights. Okay, we're coming up on 5. It should change momentarily. So there we go. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to record the temperature. The ballast is up to 4.8, and the ambient has fallen up a bit to negative 0.4. The light has come up to 31, and we are drawing 0.44 amps. And we have a VA of 51. Oh, sorry. Yeah. And we have a power factor of 0.99. And so I would continue this process for 10 minutes, 15, 20, 25, and I would go out to an hour. And I translate that into a worksheet, a spreadsheet, and a graph. And those will be posted on the website shortly. One more thing. I wanted to talk about the interference on the radio when I start some of the lamps, but not all of them. And I wanted to show you what that sounds like.
I'm a really big fan, and I'm a musician, and I'm going to make an album. And I said, and I'm going to be a singer.
It's pretty hard to hear like that, isn't it? So learn along with me as I make these comparisons. Thanks very much for your interest. So long for now.